Hey there, everybody. It's Amanda here over at the Loveable Garden. And I've got a new phone. So not only does it have this cool wider view, whereas my other phone just had, you know, your regular one-time zoom, which is kind of awkward. But this thing's got this, and my old phone didn't to do that. Hey. So yeah, Amanda here. It's finally a sunny day here in the Okanagan. And I thought good day to do a little garden update video before I head out to the second site, which we'll do an update about in this video as we're walking around and stuff. Carlstown, not so much. Here, we'll start over here, switch around for a quick second. Guys here, last year, this is under the tree, on the steps on the way down to the garden and whatnot, the yard. But so last year I had done a test patch of different things here that I thought might grow. I've never tested the soil, but I assume it's acidic soil here because of the tree. And it's just like powder puff dirt. This really hasn't, it's not a good dirt and growing area. Trying some amendments over here this year. Oh, and here's Chester's. This is like a foot of grass clippings and stuff here from cleaning up the yard. You'll see I've got like 4 or 5 plus foot grasses and stuff. So got a bit of a mulch bed or whatnot there, and we'll kind of continue it, but this is also the bird food area, feeding the birds, and all the food goes down there, so I don't really want to cover that area. The small birds for the most part eat at the feeder, but then, you know, we have pigeons and doves. I don't think the crows or magpies really eat that stuff, more so the other birds, but yeah. And I guess the sparrows, when it gets crowded, I'll have like 50 plus sparrows at a time here. So not everyone fits at the feeder and they just throw it everywhere. But anyways, so yeah, this little patch here. Last year I had tried some Brussels sprouts, some strawberries. This is Russian tarragon, and then two anises. And there was some sunflowers and stuff. Some stuff was like seeds that had fallen and just started to grow on its own, similar to this year. Whoops, if I can get over it. That there's a wheat. We got some oats there, we got sunflower. So, you know, that's just like stuff from the bird food type of thing. One of the strawberries somewhat survived. It's very tiny. There had been three of them. So yeah, that's the only dude doing anything. Look at this. Oops, stuck on the tarragon. You're so big. I was just gonna say, like, look at how big these anise are. They're just incredible. You guys are so beautiful. So anise hyssop, not anise star, but anise hyssop. Still that licorice-y taste and smell, just beautiful. And the Russian tarragon, it's similar, the black licorice type of taste and smell and stuff. But so, yeah, like, a month into the year, they were already bigger than the biggest they were last year. So I don't know, this year, I guess all the rain, the odd spring we've had here, these guys are just doing amazing. Here's my knee down here, and this guy's halfway up my, is that your calf or whatever you call that part, your thigh? And that guy, like, I've topped them so that they'll grow outwards. So, you know, he could have been even taller. But so, yeah, they're looking good. And I guess we should move on. We're already 4 minutes in. Jeez Louise. Here, this little patch. We'll see how everyone does. They definitely need a drink here. Some of them are looking a little sad. Finally got in the ground about this time last week. That's a bunch of different squashes and then a pole bean. What was the bean called? Tepary. It was from that Great American Seed Up, the seed search, or, you know, the packet, big seed package order I got. But so they're supposed to be, you know, they're from the desert of Arizona down there and stuff. They're supposed to be very heat and drought hardy. So we'll see how they go. Yeah, they just got planted and trying to get themselves figured out a bit. But yeah, and so I planted them here because the plan is I'm gonna like hang strings down from the deck. And so these guys will climb, they'll take to the strings and stuff. So yeah, I think it'll be a fun wall of squash. We'll see how it goes. And then still a couple more to be planted. I still got to get these poor barrage and sunflowers in there. What would you have been? Cilantro. Yeah, you're kind of going to seed. But so that's one thing we'll see here. Yeah, Carl's guys, if you've been following back two, probably 3+ months ago now, at my work, a fella there, one of our customers, he had a bunch of land. He had 2 acres of land, and he was looking for someone to farm it, some people, and then do some other stuff with the land as well. But so me and another guy, we were offered, you know, half each, and Carl was going to take some. So did I say, no, it's a 1 acre plot, 2 acre plot. Anyways, between the three of us, we were all going to be a third of an acre. It did start out as more, but along the weeks, things came up with Mr. Carl. I don't know. Anyways, so yeah, long story short, I was planning for a small farm. I placed an $800 seed order. I started 50 plus trays of plants. Like, just ridiculous. A couple of these, we'll go through quick. A couple of these are bought stuff, but yeah, like, I started 50 plus things of plants, and oh my goodness. But so, you know, everyone's been wanting to be in the ground for quite some time now. But so we can see over here, yeah, I've just put these guys to the side. I'm just gonna let them flower, go to seed for the, you know, flower for the bees and whatnot, and then seed I can use for the birds. But so yeah, like, I was so excited for these guys. This was our pak choi, yes, and they were looking so cute, but then they started to flower, like started to go up, and I'm like, oh man, really? But so you can see going to flower, these cute little yellow flowers here, and then these here are seed pods. But so while I'm all about seed saving, yeah, you want to save seeds from nice, big, healthy, beautiful plants, and an inch, 2 inch tall pak choi. I don't want to save that seed, but the birds can eat it. You know, you can see these seed pods, it's still going to give us proper sized seeds and whatnot, just, yeah. But so we got spinach going to seed here, another tray of spinach, this is radishes, Patra, is this more pak choi? Yeah, sad, and more radishes. But so, you know, whatever. Yeah, so with Carlstown failing, I am now tilling up the better part of my yard. I had neglected my yard as most of the stuff was going to be going to the farm. So I'm playing catch up big time, as we'll see going around. But so yeah, gonna plant whatever I hopefully can, and hopefully they're not to a point where they're, you know, going to be planting doesn't matter. You know, we'll see some of the stuff that I did plant, and you know, it was too late. It's going to seed in the ground there. But so anyways, some carrots, some onions, some radishes. Yeah, the radish tray, I don't know, it's probably at a point where it'll go to seed if I do it. Tomatoes, who do we have here? Oh yeah, marigolds and an edible flower mix. More onions. Yeah, these poor peppers seem like they've all died off. But so again, some more tomatoes there. These two are some bought stuff between, oh, I guess these guys up top here. That's a beautiful black mint. Yeah, black Peruvian mint seed that I ordered this year. We got some shiso and some rosemary. But then the rest of that tray and that tray is bought stuff. And that poor marigold there needs a water. Yeah, look at these beautiful, beautiful rosemaries. So yeah, some goodies. And then some more bought goodies. And so this tray's actually gonna go to the front yard. That's set aside there. This is broccolis. Looks like your tag's taken out, but yeah. So those guys were broccolis from seed. The back half of there, that tray is bought, but those guys are turnips, yes, from seed. And then some flowers from seed, but then again, the rest of that is bought stuff. And then, yeah, some more started trays here. You're probably broccoli, yep. Broccoli, onion, kohlrabi, dino kale, and then two bought things, but then that's a Russian red kale, yes. And this is Napa cabbages, some more tomatoes, and then bought flour. These guys are bought. And so, yeah, I guess there's the odd stuff, very little, but I did get a couple of flowers from Canadian Tire. But then other than that, yeah, I'd say Canadian Tire's like 0.2%, and then, yeah, and then Blue Mountain Nursery and Armstrong, I found them this year, so I got a good couple things from them. We'll see some beautiful grapes, and yeah, these strawberries, $2.50 each, or 10 for 10, so of course I got 10. Come on, guys. But yeah, and then the greenery, if I didn't say. You guys know I'm always at the greenery. But so yeah, so we got that. We got Patra hanging out. This section here. Yeah, I'm thinking like I'll probably clear this out a bit, but then I'll probably stop at that thistle line. We can see one here. We got thistles. Oh, that's not an earwig. That's a coney thingy. But so yeah, I'll probably leave the thistles there. I'll probably like clean this out still for planting some of those trays. But yeah, the bees absolutely love the thistles. And like when I take up these ones, I'll use that root. If these guys flower before I get to it, I'll use that flower. Thistles are pretty darn medicinal. God forbid we knew how good the weeds are for us, guys. Look into what's in your yard and what to do with it. That burdock there, she's going to flower, so she's a little past harvesting time or whatever you want to call it. But look into burdock root. We'll look at more burdock here shortly. Boop. But so yeah, you can see we've got some more trays here that are getting grown in. I've been trying to clean up the yard here. You can somewhat see I've mowed and tried to tidy. But so yeah, you've probably been noticing this and been like, what in the world's she doing here? But so same idea as landscape fabric, only I went to Value Village and got some sheets for $2 each type thing, you know? And so yeah, you can it's funny. I've weeded this half of this sheet, but you can see how puffy this is. But so yeah, with the whole Carlstown flop, this whole section here, like this was grass. I've just tilled this up in the last couple of weeks, whenever that was, 3-4 weeks ago. Tilled it up, put however many, I think it was half a yard of top mulch, or no, the mushroom blend, mushroom compost blend from Price Landscaping. They know me well over there after this season. But so yeah, some nice soil in there, tilled her all in, and yeah, put the sheets down to help suppress the weeds. You can see here, this whole sheet is just broccolis. There's some Romanesco broccoli in there and purple broccoli, and then just regular broccoli. But so yeah, I've got to lift this sheet, weed the rest of that, and I've got to weed this guy, This one here, we've got Swiss char, and then the first couple rows here was lettuce, and then Swiss char, and then this side was Napa cabbage, and were you kohlrabis? I believe so. But so yeah, definitely need to weed under that sheet. Oh, whoops. And yeah, then this sheet I had started planting spinach, hoping that I beat it, you know, that they wouldn't go to seed on me. But yeah, you can see they're going to seed on me. But so what did I do? I thought I had done two rows. Was it just the one row? Maybe. But anyways, yeah. And then this here, wait, I had done those guys, and I think it looks like that guy, not that guy, but anyways, those were some turnips. Those were the purple prince, and then we can see I've got, look at this white guy there, white turnip. But so I was going to do more turnips there, and I was going to do beets and stuff, but I just haven't gotten around to it yet. Patra. And you can see all these trays here, more stuff that I want to plant here. But so yeah, like, you know, there's just so much going on, I haven't got back to it, so the weeds are moving in. So I'm thinking I'm probably just going to take the sheets up, those spinaches, you know, they can just get tilled in, till all this in. I'll hand weed around these turnips, won't till them in. But yeah, like I gotta start from scratch here. Things have just gotten away. But so the plan too, I should say. So I wanted everyone to get a little established, a little bit bigger. And then now I'm gonna go to our local dump here in Vernon. And we have a free compost there, compost mulch blend thing. And so I had gotten a bunch of it last year. It's just nice on top to help with the moisture, keep things and whatnot. But so yeah, I'm gonna go and get some of that free mulch, and all these blankets will be covered. I just wanted everyone to get a little bit bigger first, so that I wasn't burying them in half an inch of compost, soil mulchness. What are you doing, Patra? Oh, and I guess this beauty here, that's a mountain mint from last year. So yeah, it survived the winter and it's looking beautiful, and we'll see some more of it around. I guess our tour will head on up this way now. Those of you who have been following my garden adventures for a while now might remember the wooden hexagon. So this is the planter that started it all. My first year of gardening when I was renting at beautiful Glen and Julie's in Rutland. So I put together this with a little pallet, and then when we moved, I brought her here. But so the poor thing's falling apart a bit here. And this year, I have not gotten to weeding this thing yet. But so, funny enough, okay, there we go. Yeah, these beautiful purple flowers in here. How gorgeous are you guys? So that's a sage. And I've been trying to think about it. I've been meaning to go through my photos. Oops. But so yeah, this sage is 3, if not 4 years old. And yeah, this year it just exploded this spring. I was like, wow, that's the best you've ever done. And now here it's flowering for the first time in all these years that I've had it. But yeah. Other than that, yeah, it needs a serious weeding. We got some thistles in here. We've got some prickly lettuce, wild lettuce. We'll take a look at it and talk about it in another spot. Yeah, we've got some chives in here who look like they've already flowered and now they're going to seed. Oh, here's a mint. I wonder which one you would have been. Oh, wow, look at you. They're so big because they're trying to compete. But so I was going to say, beginning of the year, I did have three or even four surviving mints and a spearmint. But so, yeah, They're buried in there somewhere. Yeah, here's the one. Are you spearmint or peppermint? Or I think you were spearmint. But so, yeah. Hopefully the other guys are alive in there somewhere, too. And Lord only knows who, what all else. Gotta love it. Here, next, we've got a little half-hexagon flower bed. So, yeah. This is a yarrow perennial, so it came back this year. It's like this little cute salmon-y, light salmon color. And then this guy's also a perennial. Or if it's not, it survived the winter. yeah, anyone else special in here? Some of this, yeah, were any of you new this year perennials? I think you might have been. Yeah, like other than those two that I just showed you, everyone else is planted this year. Look at how fun these guys are. They're such a crazy orange. And then the middles have that purple. And look at the cute little baby flowers opening in the middle. So amazing. Very cool. But so yeah, quick little flower bed there. And then, yeah, this madness here. Oh, the other way. There we are. So let's take a look from over here maybe or something. So yeah, you guys might remember I had different hexagon beds. So this, and then last year, the two at the back I had combined. This year, I've combined these three. And yeah, things are a little behind. I tried a little technique I tried last year, and let's just say last year it went a lot better than this year. This year it didn't really produce much of what I was wanting at all. But so, I had, this was all seeded, like beautiful lines, rows. This should be an abundance of food right now, plants. But so I seeded it and I put down white sheets over top to save from the birds picking at it and the cats digging them up and stuff. But so yeah, I did it last year too, and things are supposed to. They did grow, and eventually your sheet gets puffy, like we saw with the weeds over there. And then, you know, things are big enough that you can take the cover off, and away you go. Things are nice and established. But so we can see here, we've got a dino kale. Here we've got a tiny little Russian kale. Geez, have they mostly died off now? Here we've got, you know, a couple little beets. There was some radishes, a couple spots of radishes. Looks like they've died off since I took the covers off. But yeah, anyways, not a whole lot happening. I took the cover off and it was like, what the heck? But so anyways, I've gone and planted some stuff and we'll be planting lots more. All those strawberries that we saw. I've got to weed this here. But there is a big patch of strawberries there that for all I know is full of strawberries right now, hopefully. But so those strawberries are already there. So I'll probably put those other 10 that I just bought around about in here too. Make it a nice little strawberry patch. And yeah, need to do some weeding. Like that stuff that you're seeing there is bindweed, my nemesis bindweed. But yeah, we've got some peppers that I've planted, and then four more peppers there, and then they're small. Yeah, like that's a tomato. Is there any more tomatoes around here? Oh, there's another tomato behind you. Who are you? Oh, you're a weed. A good weed, but still. Some peppers. Yeah, there's like kind of some tomatoes in here. Well, not kind of. There was a lot of tomatoes in here that I planted from my trays. But yeah, they're kind of spindly and kind of seems like some of them have died off. But anyways, lots more to keep planting. So it does, you know, I'm not too worried about people dying off at this point. I shouldn't say that. I don't want them to die off. We're at a point in the season where, geez Louise here. But yeah, this beauty. We've got two onions. and they're going to flower and seed. But so yeah, I've been watching this guy. I've been watching them both. Oh, we can see. Let's, there we are. Yeah, you can see it has like this protective circle around it, and this one's starting to break through. But so yeah, this one over the last couple days here has been breaking through. Come on, focus. So those flowers will be opening up shortly here. Beautiful. And yeah, so we'll see more when I get over there, but yeah, soup really need to do a weed in back there. Usually I've got some stuff planted along the fence. I think I might just leave that section for this year, but yeah, there is still a pathway that should be over there, so I gotta find my pathway so I can get to the other side of these beds and whatnot. And funny enough, yeah, I'll show you those mustards when we get over there. They're huge! But so speaking of mustards, like even these guys are a decent size here. Oh yeah, this guy here, he's up to my head. This bed, I tried to tie up this mustard. I'm gonna have to do it a little better. But so hiding under it, we've got some self-seeded squashes. If you remember last year, this bed had like a bajillion squash come up, because I guess there was stuff in the compost that I had mixed in, some seeds and stuff. So yeah, anyways, like I haven't put any new seeds. This is still, I guess, seeds that didn't germinate last year and now they're doing their thing. But so yeah, like how beautiful are you beauties? And then we got some nettle here too. I think it's dead nettle, it's not stinging nettle. Unfortunately, I'd prefer stinging nettle. Not something you hear from most folks, but I'm not most folks, because I know what the plants do. But so yeah, here's this prickly lettuce that we were just talking about over there. Wild lettuce. So this thing is crazy medicinal and good for you. I don't want to speak about it too much because I'm just learning myself, to be honest. Yeah, but look into the plants in your yard. That thing's going to help you with a whole lot of stuff. But you know, you need to research things and know what it's going to do too. Yeah, anyways, here we got some cute lettuces. And then this beaut is a parsnip that's gone to flower and seed. You can see here we got the cute little flowers. And then here we got the cute little seeds that are forming. Now in behind here, we've got some bigger tomatoes. So these guys were bought. And I'm not sure who these two beauties are. But yeah, they're a type of tree. I was wondering if they were choke cherries. We got choke cherries kind of behind us. Now I'm kind of wondering if they might be apples, or I'm not sure. But yeah, self-seeded, just popping up. And they are doing amazing this year. Beautiful. Oh, and I guess I forgot to point out when we were over in that section there with the squashes and stuff. But so, speaking of choke cherry trees, there is actually a whole bunch of them planted there. They were all sprouting over here. And then I dug them up before doing my tilling and stuff. And I planted them here hoping they'd still survive. But yeah, the vast majority of them have died off at this point. Sad, sad, sad. But yeah. So yeah, I keep the good weeds around. You can see we got some prickly lettuces. And what were you guys? St. John's Golden Margaret or something. But so yeah, these poor flowers here and this char and there's a beet. These poor guys were all standing up and they're like 2-3 feet tall, but they were surrounded by weeds and tall grasses. So I just weeded like a week ago, week and a half, and yeah, they're all so tall and didn't have any support anymore, so everyone's fallen over. Like, yeah, you can see it's a tall plant. They were all standing up, but that's all right. It's just a mess of flowers now. And yeah, we can see the poor beet and the poor char. You know, they had gone to flower and seed. But so yeah, that guy survived the winter and is doing its thing. And where's our beet hiding in back here? So that's pretty cool. And this is a Veronica, who I always love. Reminds me of one of my childhood besties down in Murica now. But I got her here in my garden with me all the time. Veronica. This is an Amanda lettuce. So that guy's self-seeded. I've bought some Amanda lettuce 3 years ago now, maybe even four. And funny enough, like, it started out in that wood hexagon. And then when it goes to flower and seed, the lettuce seeds blow in the wind easily. So yeah, now in the years that, like, it just keeps traveling. I just keep finding it in different spots of the yard. But yeah, just made a salad with the bottom portion here the other night. It's so delicious. And like the most beautiful salad you could have ever seen. Threw in some of the red ones that we'll see in a moment too. But like this green is just incredible, especially in a salad. It looked so good. And it was so good. Anyone else hiding down in here? Yeah, so again, lots of space left in this garden, this bed still, so gonna be planting some goodness. Oh, I guess we missed you guys in back here. Bought from the greenery some yellow and purple cauliflowers, and I don't know why these two purple cauliflowers are going to flower and seed already. And yeah, I don't know what these guys are doing here. But anyways, we'll see what happens there. And yeah, now this bed's new this year. Patrick's hanging out in the shade. But so yeah, just tilled all this up. Like I say, so we've got big choke cherries here, and then we got some choke cherries over there, and choke cherries that patch there behind the fence. But so, between falling just on their own and the birds and stuff, there was so many little choke cherry trees popping up. It was so cute. But so I dug them up, like I said a few minutes ago, planted them there. Hoped I would save most, some of them, but not so much. But so yeah, I've tilled this up. I put more of that mushroom blend compostness, and yeah, trying, working away at getting stuff in the ground. Oh, so we got some baby lettuces here. So yeah, that beautiful salad I talked about the other night, threw in some of this beautiful redness too. Over here we've got some of that red Russian kale that we've seen in the trays, and then some regular curly kale. Yeah, keep working away there. You guys were kohlrabis or broccoli? Pretty sure kohlrabi. And then these guys need a water. They're not looking too hot, or they're looking pretty hot, however you want to word it. But, three little rows of peas here. And yeah, funny enough, you know, they're already peeing. So yeah, you guys aren't looking too good. They need a little water. I thought they'd enjoy the shade, though, at least. But, yeah. Miss Patra enjoys the shade. And then here. Oh, here's one of them. So, it's four, or did it end up being five? One, two, three, four? Anyways, four or five rows here of cabbages. And then in between the rows, I've put beets. So yeah, we'll see how everyone takes to everything and stuff. But they're looking cute and good. And then, yeah, we passed some trays of beets here. So more beets to be going in. Getting through it, finally. Hey, Badra, we're getting through the beets. Ba-dum-ba-dum. I guess that's that. I guess last year, if you remember those tours, we'd go up the side of the house and I had a bed there too, but yeah, this year it's just tall grass. We can see the grass beside that tree there. Let's go look at that grass, actually. That's hilarious. Jeez. Okay, let's switch. This guy is taller than me. Like, how fabulous is that grass? Oh my goodness. That's But so yeah, there's the patch, you know, where I'd usually grow stuff in the past years, but I don't know that we're gonna do anything this year. Stuff never really grows here too much anyways. It's nice and sunny now, but yeah, this spot with the sun, yeah, doesn't get enough. This stuff doesn't really produce. Oh, Patrick's getting a drink. Yeah, you can see a couple more baby lettuces to get into the ground. But yeah, those guys are doing great since they've been in. Yeah, and that'll be more lettuces again there. That's four different types. We've got a red one, romaine, and then you guys were like a crispy one. Kind of similar leaf to the Amanda we saw there. But so yeah, so usually the tour, we'd go around this way and there should be a path there. But yeah, not much of a path there at the moment. But so yeah, working our way back. 36 minutes, jeez Louise. Quite the tour here. Yeah, the plum tree. That's beaut. If you saw the one video I posted on Facebook a week or so ago, I posted about the ladybug larvas moving in. But so yeah, we can see here, these leaves are all curled. We got them dying. Am I seeing any fruit at this point? I think. Oh wow, there's one lone plum up there. Oh man. Yeah, the vast majority of the plums have died off here. Oh, here's two. See those? Hey, gorgeouses. Yeah, the silly aphids this year with the weather, I guess. They have just moved in. I'm hearing they're hitting everyone's. It's not good. Not good at all. But so, I had the ladybug larva army move in. I don't know if we can see any of them right now. That video I did a week ago. Oh yeah, here's some right here. So that's those guys there are ladybug larvas. And so when people say that you want ladybugs for your aphids, it's more so those guys. This are even two stages before the ladybug. I think this guy here, you're kind of weird looking. Yeah, there's the stage before ladybug. They look like that, and then they start getting puffy and fat and starting to change into their orange color with their spots. That's so neat. We're seeing this circle of life right there. But so yeah, so anyways, guys, they eat aphids, rah, rah, rah. But so yeah, there was a crap ton of them here last week. But yeah, I think it might have been a hair too late. Poor tree. Next year is the year. But so yeah, like if we look around, there's just offshoots everywhere. I really need to dig up and disperse these guys too. That's not helping. It's just so crowded, like for airflow alone. But yeah, then you get pests in here and it's just a nightmare. But so anyways, and then yeah, talking about tall things here, we were over at that tall grass a second ago. Watch out, Patra. Mom wants to stand beside the mustards. Oh, I guess hiding down in here under all these weeds and mustards, we got some chives. This little rectangle had been a planting spot last year. I guess it doesn't look like the artichokes from last year survived. But yeah, let's get flipped around here for a sec again. Look at these mustards. They're huge. This is ridiculous. But so yeah, they're so tall. Like, this big patch here. Whoops. like when we're looking over here, we see all these beautiful flowers. Oh, it's all these mustards here. No, these mustards are from over there. They just got so heavy with the rain and so big and tall and heavy, they went oh dear. But so yeah, like how amazing is nature? You just saw, I had my hand full up there. Like, I don't know how tall I am, plus my arm length. It's pretty amazing. Crazy nature. But so moving along, yeah, I guess I should say here, got a couple perennials in here. So that guy's doing all right. I forget who you were. I remember the flower. It's going to be a gorgeous, beautiful flower. The irises, they did their thing. They were beautiful as always. But yeah, I just weeded in here. So these other ones are a little smaller, but they're coming along. Some perennials, and then we've got this bush dude here. I think it's like a mallow type bush. And yeah, definitely need to do some weeding here and need to get some stuff in the ground. But so, yeah, more plum trees hiding in under behind the plum trees. My hazcap is going nuts this year. And wow, I haven't looked at you in a couple days. Whew! You guys are getting colorful now. Sweet! So hazcaps are an incredibly nutritious, delicious berry, if you haven't heard of them or seen them. Yeah.
Wow, look at you guys. Wow!
But so yeah. What would they taste like? They're even yummier than a blueberry, I think. But you have to get them when they're ripe. See, people, they'll see them color up and they're like, oh wow, that's ready to be harvested. But yeah, oh, see how easy that one broke off? Let's see how ripe it is. That was all right, but it probably could have used a couple days still. So with these guys, you know, you're gonna see them turn color and you're gonna be like, oh, it's ready. But no, it still needs another week or two. Yeah, they're a tricky one. You gotta give them time to sweeten up. And so I thought that one might maybe with how easy it broke off. But yeah, you'll know more closer when they're ready if you just like touch them and they just come off easy breezy. Or even like wait till they fall on the ground. Oh, but so here's another one of those ladybugs that's in that stage before ladybug. Right on. And you might be noticing too the color on the leaves here, that they're not discolored. That's just literally aphid filth, aphid crap from the plum trees above. It's crazy. Oh, crazy. But so yeah. Oh wow, you're finally flowering. Oh my god, thank god we're doing this video, or I might not have missed that. I was just gonna complain. I was gonna use the B word, shouldn't swear. I was just gonna complain about this thing. This is a polar berry, and I've had it 4 years, I want to say, and this is its first year flowering, finally, because it's one similar to the raspberries where it sends up new shoots each year. So, yeah. Wow. Yay, Patra, that's pretty cool. I'll finally maybe get a polar berry or two this year. It's supposed to be a white blackberry, I think. Wow, its tag is still here all these years. But yeah, a white blackberry. Cool. See what happens there. And here's our oh-so-loved little baby apple from seed, same time as that beaut. Silliness. And yeah, raspberries galore this year. We're gonna see the raspberries from the other angle here, but yeah, just craziness. And then my maples again from seed. Where's the third one? Oh, there he is. Yeah, beautiful maple trees. Oh, I just remembered your name a second ago. Well, anyways, these are a weed again, or a wild native plant, or whatever you want to call them. And yeah, again, very nutritious, delicious. Oh, and yeah, I've got another maple back there too from seed. Look at all these raspberries coming in. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this here. Oh, and look, there's another one of those ladybugs. This guy has cap that I got last year. And then we've got a beautiful honeysuckle. Oh, and there's another one of those ladybugs. Oh, are we seeing them? There we are. Oh, and there's another guy. Crazy. It's good. Good, good, good. But so, yeah, this area here, last year I had tomatoes and peppers. But this year, I think I'm just going to fill it with berries. But so right now we're looking at a bunch of stupid bindweed. Silly bindweed and the odd thistle. But so pretty amazing too with the raspberries. You know, you get new shoots coming up this year. Each year, not this year. But so you can see we got one there. And it's amusing, right? Like, you look at where the raspberries are, the closest one's like a foot away for that guy, a foot and a half, two for that guy. Oh, wow, we've got some. Oh, no, that's that. I was going to say, holy, we got one here, too. But, yeah. Who are you? Oh, you're the grape at my foot. But, so, yeah, raspberries are doing awesome. Raspberries everywhere. And so, yeah, new this year, that Blue Mountain Nursery place, I got two super awesome grapes. And so they're like those pink grapes. I'm hoping they're the ones that Sadi has from the market, because, oh my gosh, I love those so much. And then, yeah, I guess this came from Rona. It's a yellow raspberry, golden raspberry. These guys came from the greenery, some perennials, peony, and a lily? Daylily, yeah. Nice. And then these guys are from, oh, what do you call it? Shoot. Anyways, in Lake Country, the Tim's there, when you're coming from Vernon down to Lake Country, first Tim's on your right, and the fruit stand there. They're one of the farmers from the farmer's market. Oh, that's gonna bug me now. Anyways, these guys came from them. So the HazCap that we just saw, I got that from them last year. And so I was like, I wonder if they have more this year and what all they have. But so yeah, super awesome. Got two more HazCaps from them. And we can see there's some berries on those buttes too. And then got two gooseberries as well. And I've been meaning to look up the gooseberries. I don't know if I'm supposed to harvest them while they're green or now they're starting to turn red. And yeah, I guess, where is it? Somewhere in there, I do have a gooseberry too, actually. And it came from the market as well, but a different grower. Oh yeah, there it is. But so, yeah. And then here, we've got one of those beautiful mountain mints that we saw over there. And, oh yeah. My big, beautiful from seed apple tree. We've got, yeah, just Raspberry City. There are two wooden beds back there. Lord only knows what's growing right now. Could be anything, could be nothing. Oh, looks like we got some lemon balm, which I was just going to show here too. Yeah, we got lemon balm throughout. And then kind of here-ish, we've got lemon balm, but we've also got some mints. So that one's a wild, like, native mint, local to us. The black currant is doing super awesome this year, as is the red currant. And we can see how gorgeous the red currants are turning color. Gorgeous. But yeah, look at how beautiful these lemon balm is. And then here we got three strawberries from last year. So they're doing their thing. Another cute maple. We got more of that native mint. It smells so amazing. Like, that's my favorite mint of all the mints that I have, that I've seen. It's just fabulous. Oh, and then these cute little yellow flowers. That's actually an oregano. Yeah, I started weeding in here the other night, but then it got late, and I didn't want to be cutting any of my beautiful lemon balm or mint. But so, yeah, I think that's about wrapped up our tour now. We'll see what I do here. That's where I should do my greens, maybe. Maybe, I don't know, there's a lot of grass there. Whoops, wind. Yeah, I did just get a bunch of different greens this week from Fieldstone. So I was hoping to grow some spelt, some corazon, buckwheat. Some grains, you know. Talking big grain shortages here. I was going to do a little patch. Oh, I guess for you. You are getting destroyed by weeds here. Stupid bindweed. Oh, man. Yeah, this is chokeberry. And then chokecherry is what I have over there. But so this is chokeberry. And, it didn't. Last year, it was just covered in flowers. This year, not so much. So there's a handful of berries coming in, not overly much. Oh, and the greenhouse that I put back together this year. Yeah. I think that's about it. Wraps us up here. Yeah, so I'm lacking on the sunflowers. Driving around seeing the size of everyone else's sunflowers right now. I am behind. So I guess we did see I've got a few of them in that tray over there, and there's a few self-seeded ones throughout. But yeah, I gotta get a bunch more sunflower seeds in the ground, guys. You know I love my sunflowers. This year's just been all messed up. Oh, that silly Carl fiasco. Look at how incredible this is without me paying attention to it. Could have been that much better had I been focusing on it and had the time, and oh my goodness. But it's still gonna be awesome. We're early in the year. Summer's just finally getting here. Officially 2-3 days ago, but in terms of temperature, finally seems like today. Awesome possum, guys. Well, yeah, I should wrap this up. We're at 52 minutes here, pushing 53. You always plan for a quick garden tour, but yeah, I guess it's been quite a while, so we had quite a bit to catch up on. And I've still got a fair bit of planting and work to do, so yeah. Oh, I guess one thing I don't think I specified there when I was giving the Carl update. But so yeah. Carlstown, it has fallen through and stuff, but so at the shop there, you know, here I'd been telling all the customers, like, oh, gonna grow stuff for the community. It's gonna be super awesome. Come to my little farm, farmers market, this, that, the next thing. So, you know, people were excited and they're getting all the updates, all these trays I'm starting, all these plants. But thankfully, one door closes, another opens. Not quite as much space, but still a fair bit of space. We're gonna grow a bit of food, not as much, but still a fair bit. But so yeah, one of the customers over at the shop there, funny enough, so Carl's was like 3 minutes away. This guy's place is literally like halfway to Carl's. And so not as much space as it was going to be at Carl's, a third of an acre, but yeah, the one plot's, what's the one plot? 30 by 50 or so. And then a couple raised beds and a dog run that's, what, 15 or 20 by 20? Maybe, yeah, 15 by 20, 10 by 20. It's a decent little size, too. Good spot. Caged off and stuff. Or fenced off. But so, yeah. So, between here and there, still going to be growing a fair bit of food, and hopefully things still grow, as I say. Hopefully they're not stunted from being in their trays for so long. But yeah, super duper. So I guess that's that update until the next one from Mike's place to show you what's been going on there and what we're doing. Alrighty, but so yeah, I guess I should wrap this video up now. Hope you guys are all doing well, the season's going well, and yeah, hope you're living life, enjoying life, loving life, doing you all day, every day. I know there's a lot of stuff going on in the world right now, but yeah, just do you guys. I have all these, you know, big thoughts and big sentences and big things throughout the day that I want to share, inspire people. And then you get the camera on and it's, you know, you just go blank or you can't find the words. But yeah, you know, if you don't produce, you won't be happy. I think that was Jim Rohn. Might have been Napoleon Hill. Pretty sure that was Jim Rohn. But yeah, you don't produce, you won't be happy. And you know, whether that's getting out there and gardening, or whether that's building something, or, you know, learning a new skill. Oh, hey, we got a little, oh, he's gone. A native bee. Haven't really been seeing the native bees yet. That's good. Seeing one. One whole bee. But yeah, guys. Got so many unhappy people out there right now. What are you doing? You know? If I'm not at working, you know, I'm doing stuff. I'm keeping busy all day, every day. I'm exhausted, don't get me wrong. But I'd rather be doing stuff. I'd rather be exhausted than not doing stuff. And I don't know, I just don't understand people these days. You're unhappy. Yeah. I should stop rambling. This was going to be a garden video. It was a garden video. Yeah, I just want you guys to go out and chase your dreams, live your life, love your life, do what you love. You don't know what you love? Go start looking into things. How are you going to find new stuff that you potentially love? If you're sitting on the couch, if you're sitting on the screen, you know, get out there, talk to people, get involved with the community, get involved on your local farms, you know, I don't go to church, I believe various things, but you know, if church is your thing, go get involved at church, you know, go volunteer, go, you know, start that, you know, you want to be an entrepreneur, you got something you want to do, like, support you. One of the podcasts I listened to lately, it was Zig Ziglar's Son on a Farm podcast. And, you know, he said, you got to work for someone. Why not work for yourself? You know, you're not being appreciated at work. You've got these skills, these talents, these gifts. Get out there, guys. Do you. But so, yeah. Anyways. Chase those dreams. Get out, enjoy that sunshine. It's good for us. No matter what they tell you. Yeah. Anyways, wrapping her up. Love you guys. Peace and love. Till next time. Keep gardening. Keep doing you. And I guess I usually like to close out with a cat. But I don't know where the cats are at. They've left this hour-long tour. Too much for them. I'll leave you guys with the bird. Say bye, tweeters. You guys are so cute. Is that picking up food flying? They are just throwing food everywhere right now. They're so silly. Goofballs. Alrighty. Yeah. That should wrap her up. Thanks, guys. Till next time. Lots of love.